So, you've been tasked with energy monitoring for your facility and have been provided with a software tool, but you're unsure where to start. No worries, I'm here to help you configure your dashboards in no time. But first, let's go over some basic concepts you need to know. Dashboards is an application to view high-level historical and real-time data, for example key performance indicators, KPIs. The information in the dashboards application is accessed through dashboards with gadgets. Dashboards are saved in the dashboard library. Gadgets are graphical display objects used in the dashboard display pane. For charting trends over time, or in comparison with correlated measurements or similar functionality, the gadgets available for a dashboard are listed in the Gadget Setup dialog, which opens when you click Add Gadget in the dashboard controls area. If the system has been deployed for some time and there are other users or groups, it is likely that you will come across some dashboards with gadgets in the library. In the current version PME 2023 R2, there are a total of 24 gadgets, classified into 8 categories to simplify your selection. Additionally, you can use the search gadget box to find specific gadgets by name. 3 out of the 8 categories require an additional license apart from the server-based license. The categories called Power Quality Details and Power Quality Overview require the Power Quality Performance license. Ensure that this license has been activated before using these gadgets. The category called Usage Analysis also requires a license called Energy Dashboard Analysis. To use any gadgets in this category, ensure that the license is activated by the system administrator. It's important to note that dashboards can be classified into 2 groups, historic data and real-time data. It's crucial to differentiate between these 2 concepts to make the right selection. Real-time data is pulled in real-time from the devices, requiring communication with the devices to visualize the information. In the event of communication loss, no data will be displayed. On the other hand, historic data comes from the database. Whether or not you have communication with the source, the information will come from the database when you want to check it. Gadget configuration. Let's take the bar chart as an example. Typically, the first step for all gadgets is to provide the title. You also have 2 optional features, to hide the title or modify the opacity. Except for the power quality gadgets, web viewer, and KPI, for all the other gadgets, the next step is to modify the display settings, including the font size, precision, and background color. The third part for some of the gadgets is to configure the chart settings. Not all gadgets have this property. Here, you have the option to include or exclude the data points. If you select No, you can hover the mouse over the gadget, and a tooltip will display the data. Additionally, you can customize the background color of the gadget or add a watermark. Finally, we get to the data series, where you basically have 3 buttons to add, edit, or remove the measurement you want to visualize. It's important to be careful because some gadgets only allow you to choose 1 measurement by design, while others allow more than 1. Let's begin by adding the first measurement. The window is divided into 2 panes. On the left side, you choose the source of the data, and on the right pane, you choose the measurement. Sources are organized depending on whether you have configured hierarchies in advance. Hierarchies can be defined as groups of devices. For example, if you have 3 meters that measure the energy usage of the light bulbs in your office and you want to know the total energy used by lighting, you need to group your 3 meters. That's an example of a hierarchy. If your system does not have hierarchies configured, your sources will be organized by groups according to the naming convention in your system. For example, in an international project with devices located in 3 different countries, Canada, Czechia, India, and France, lattes, the folders follow this distribution. You will also find another folder called VIP, which stands for Virtual ION Processor, but this is a virtual component used for advanced operation that you will learn about at a later point. When the hierarchies are configured, the Sources folder will appear slightly different. Initially, you will find only two folders called Devices and Physical Layout. Within the Devices folder, your sources will be organized by groups, following the naming convention in your system, similar to before. Inside the Physical Layout folder, you will find the hierarchies of devices. Just below the source's title, there is a text box where you can type the name of the source, if you remember it, of course. Next to it, in the bottom right corner, there is a small text that reads Show Advanced. You can click there to filter your sources by type. Now, let's talk about the Measurements pane. To see the list of measurements, you need to first select any device from the sources list. Depending on the type of device, e.g., relays, basic meters, advanced meters, RTUs, the list of measurements might vary. At the top, there's a search box where you can type the name of the measurement. Similar to the sources section, below the box in the bottom right corner, there's a message that reads Show Advanced. Click there and verify that the Display Only Measurements with Historical Data option is checked. Otherwise, the list may only show measurements for real-time data, and you will not see any historical data. There are two more additional filters that you can use, Type and Show. In the lower part, you can adjust the display name of the measurement, which generally includes the source name and the measurement. You can change it if needed. Additionally, you can add the units. By default, this option is not selected. You can also change the series style, color, and apply a multiplier if needed. Finally, you can select the time range in the viewing period section. Once the gadget is built, you can easily enable or disable sources by simply clicking on the legends, making your analysis more convenient. Additionally, you can maximize the window by clicking on the square at the top left corner and adjust the time range from the top drop-down menu to suit your needs. It's also possible to download the displayed data into a CSV file for use in Excel. Depending on your gadget, you may have the option to print the image in different formats, such as PNG, JPG, SVG, among others. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and look forward to seeing you soon on this journey.